Now, as we are saying that ki environment is nothing but the interactions, your surroundings, our surroundings, interaction and everything which is there. Now, tell me, what are the interactions? Like, how could you say the interactions are? Interactions between biotic and abiotic environment. Still? Terrestrial environment. So whatever you project on, as it is, you say abiotic or you say biotic, if you say interaction between the land, the plants, the animals or whatever it is, ultimately it comes to us. That is your living organisms or living creatures which is there. Yes? Now what is this living? Living. Which is living? Which can live. Not which can life, which can live, I suppose. Yes? So what is life then? What is living? What is life? Movement? Only movement? Energy? Axis? Axis of? Axis? Actions? Okay. Still more. Metabolic processes. Logical thinking, which nobody has here, even me. Still. Walking. Okay, plants will not walk. Are they non-living? No, madam. So whatever you say together, we can form it into a simpler sentence. Everything is, yes, correct. Metabolic activities, all the actions. Okay, all other respiratory processes or whatever you had said. So a living organism is nothing but which has or which can do its own metabolic physiological processes by itself and also can reproduce its own kind. Clear? Now this can move if I give any kind of mechanical energy, if I move it. Yes, this is a product, but we cannot reproduce it or this cannot reproduce itself. Understood? This is a product, this is a produce, but it cannot reproduce this same thing again. Plants can reproduce, yes, production, producing again and again. A plant, then you get the fruits, seeds, then again a new plant will be coming out. Human beings, animals, microorganisms. So living or life is nothing but which can have their own processes or metabolic activities which are there and which can reproduce by themselves. Clear now? This is known as a living, or the organisms are known as living organisms. It can be very tiny, which you cannot see them, which are known as microorganisms. They can be very bigger or very larger than you, like your elephants and all. They are known as larger or macroorganisms which are there. It can be in only one cell, like your amoeba, your yeast or any other bacteria which is there. It can be multicellular, like means so many cells. Two or more cells are known as multicellular. All these are known as living organisms. Got it? Now you could have a doubt, how have they evolved? Yes? So many will be having doubt. How this life came? How did it come? We have many theories, many hypotheses, yes? I'll do one thing, I'll explain, then I'll write so that you can note it down then. Yes, so that is about living, unicellular, multicellular or whatever is there. Now you could have the doubt, like how did this life come? For everything there will be a start point. Yes or no? So that start point of your living which is there, or the existence of life forms, we call it to be the origin. Okay, from that origin, it is not the same. Now, all of a sudden, no one have experimentalized or no one have invented this one. It was a normal pencil which is there, then an ink pen, then some other pen, then an alcoholic pen, then slowly it turned up into this marker pen which is present. This is used for some other purposes. When we had these whiteboards, instead of these chalkboards, we are using this pen which is there. Yes, so from a normal slate pencil or normal thing, this much have evolved till here. So that slate pencil or whatever is there is the origin. And next, the dynamic changes which had occurred, we call it to be evolution. Clear now? So origin is a start point. Evolution is nothing but the changes which are there. You can say it can't be a final change. Now also we are evolving. Now also the process metabolic activities are going on. Even we are changing also. If it is not changing, then what would have happened? We all will be similar. Andram okela kanipistamu. Yes, with only same physical features which are there. But that's not there. We have many changes. We have many differences. So that is known as evolution. Clear now? Now how this has started, how origin have started, and how we had evolved, I will be letting you know. There are many theories and hypotheses for that. This is just as a running notes which is there. Mutations are nothing but the genetical changes which occur, okay? Thank you. ఇక్కడ ప్రస్తుతానికి బయోడైవర్సిటీ ఇక్కడ ఆగండి. బయోడైవర్సిటీ 2 డేస్ టాపిక్ అది, లేటర్ ఆన్ ఐల్ బి లెటింగ్ యు నో. మేజర్ టాపిక్ ఇన్ యువర్ ఎన్వైరన్మెంట్ అండ్ ఎకాలజీ ఇస్ యువర్ బయోడైవర్సిటీ. Done? Life on earth. Okay, how did this life start on your earth is nothing but, as you know, science will not believe if it doesn't have any kind of proof, any kind of evidence, or at least any kind of hypothesis. Proof, you know. Yes, evidence, you know. What is hypothesis? Assumption. This could have happened, it could have happened, aisa hua hoga. Okay, so those all are hypothesis, because nobody went in 5 billion years ago and nobody said this had happened, this blue green algae came like this and all. So whatever the origin and the starting of evolution which is there was totally dependent on different kinds of evidences from our evolutionary things. Like it can be from your fossil fuels, it can be from your other artifacts which are present, or other books which are there, or other hypothesis experiments which have been done by different scientists at that time. It can be Oparin, it can be Aristotle, Charles Darwin, like that, so many things had happened. Now, coming to life, as you know, Earth was a very ball of ice at that time. This temperature wasn't there at that time. It was very cold. So minus degrees was there at that time. And there, you didn't have any kind of nascent oxygen or normal oxygen which was there. Oxygen was associated either with the carbon dioxide, like CO2, yes, or either little bit droplets of water which was there, or either with some other things like any kind of carbohydrates or any kind of organic material which was present. In the starting, you used to have only the elemental things which are there. You would have seen in the periodic table, hydrogen, helium, lithium and all, the elemental things which are there. Now leave about all those physical and chemical things which are there. We'll start our subject from Big Bang Theory. You could have heard this. Whenever you start reading any kind of physics, chemistry or biology, this is the first thing which comes. Chemistry, in that you will be dealing with all the elements which have formed due to the temperature differences. Physics, due to the Big Bang that had occurred because of various reasons which are there. In biology, you will be reading about the different organic gases which have evolved from this Big Bang. This is a hypothesis that the universe used to be very small. యూనివర్స్ అంత చాలా చిన్నగా ఒక డ్రాప్ లాగా ఉండేది. ఓకే, సంథింగ్ హ్యాడ్ హ్యాపెండ్ ఇన్ సైడ్ దాట్, ద గేషియస్ థింగ్స్, ఫ్యూజన్, ఫిజన్ రియాక్షన్స్, ఇవన్నీ అవ్వడం వల్ల ఒకేసారి అది ఎక్స్ప్లోర్ అయ్యింది. ఎక్స్ప్లోజన్ ఇస్ 2 వేస్, ఒకేసారి స్కాటర్ అయిపోవడం, సెకండ్ టైం ఎక్స్ప్లోజన్ అలా అలా ఇంక్రీజ్ అవ్వడం. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎక్స్పాండింగ్ ఇట్ స్పేస్ విచ్ ఇస్ దేర్. ఇప్పుడు కూడా ద యూనివర్స్ ఇస్ ఎక్స్పాండింగ్. ఓకే, ఇవన్నీ థియరీస్ పక్కన పెట్టండి. వాట్ ఈస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ టు అస్? ఈ బిగ్ బ్యాంగ్ థియరీ వల్ల ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇస్ స్కాటర్డ్ అండ్ ఆల్, రొటేషన్, రెవల్యూషన్, గ్రావిటీ ఇవన్నీ ఫామ్ అయ్యాయి ఒకటి తర్వాత ఒకటి, ఇట్ హాస్ ఫార్మ్ లైక్ దాట్. సో వాట్ హ్యాపెండ్ హియర్ వాజ్, అంత కూల్గా ఉన్న ఎర్త్ డ్యూ టు ద కెమికల్ చేంజెస్ విచ్ వాజ్ దేర్ స్లోలీ స్లోలీ స్టార్టెడ్ టు గెట్ హీటన్ అప్ by the greenhouse gases which are there. We had seen the greenhouse gases, the carbon dioxide and all other things which are there. Adi kaakunda, we had methane, we had ethane, yes, we had volcanic eruptions. Itlanti vanni avadam valla heat annadi koncham koncham it started to decrease. In between there were so many other processes which were going on. Now coming to here, mana hypothesis kochesthe, like life kosam vachesthe, we have chemosynthetic theory. స్పాంటేనియస్ జనరేషన్, అండ్ యు హ్యావ్ ఆర్గానిక్ ఎవల్యూషన్. There are many other theories, but whatever are important, those only I'm dealing here. First, we'll see spontaneous generation. Spontaneous generation lo enti ante, very, you know what is spontaneous, right? Then and there, appadikappudu antam kada, like that. So what have some of the Greek scientists have told ki, like normally you find snakes in mud. So something had happened that from mud, automatically the snakes, the reptiles started to evolve. Birds normally, they live on trees. So something had happened that an egg has formed and spontaneously they had turned into these birds which are there. So this hypothesis didn't have any kind of experimental proof. Then and there you cannot say like that. So this was totally rejected by many of the scientists. Second, we had this chemosynthetic theory. Chemo is chemicals. Synthetic here defines that the process which is there, okay, the development which is there. E chemosynthetic theory lo enti ante stage wise ga, there are so many stages, almost you have 6 stages in that. Andulone enti ante ee chemicals em aithe unnayo, like for example, what are proteins made up of? Polypeptides of antena, yes, like carbohydrates gaani, like you take fats for example, what anniki oka molecular substance untundi, the base substance which is there. Now these amino acids are made up of certain substances like carbon, nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, ilanti vanni, yes. So like that there are different stages where you had the start of conservative heaps. What do you mean by a heap? Heap. A pile or a stack of any material which is there. Books anni techi oka daggara esayandi. That's a heap of books which is there. Or stack of books which is there. Heap is nothing but little molecules unna vaativi. Okay? Manaki ippudu we had said that there are many volcanic eruptions and all which are there. And second thing, nascent oxygen ledu. Molecular oxygen was not there. So many ozone layer was also not there at that time. Because of which many meteors, asteroids used to come and they used to just stab the earth's surface which is present. Ila, because of many other calamities also, you used to have, the earth wasn't in a, ippudu kuda itlanti structure kadu, but normally you used to have dungs or some other lower objects which are there. Dung untundi kada, the opposite of heap which is there. Heap is piling up, okay, normally if you go down. For example, you leave a mug of water for 1 week, what will happen? Evaporation inside your washroom, for example. Sides pattukunte, you will feel that slimy layer which is there, the moss you can say. Inka atla odlesthe algae form avutundi, fungus vastundi and all. This moss, whatever is present, is nothing but in still water, if you leave like that, all the organic material will come down. Precipitation, sedimentation or whatever you call. Ivanni kindaku vachesi reaction start avutundi kada. The same way here also what happened, because of these dungs and all the organic material which was there, చిన్న చిన్నగా వచ్చి ఇక్కడ ఉండిపోవడం స్టార్ట్ అయింది. ఉండిపోతే ఏమవుతుంది? సమ్ ఆల్ ఆర్ కెమికల్స్, కెమికల్ రియాక్షన్ విల్ బి అకరింగ్. సో నార్మల్ ఎమైనో యాసిడ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ దేర్ ఆర్ నార్మల్ కెమికల్ సబ్స్టెన్సెస్, ప్రైమరీ కెమికల్ సబ్స్టెన్సెస్ ఫార్మ్డ్ ఇంటూ సెకండరీ కెమికల్ సబ్స్టెన్సెస్, దెన్ దే ఫార్మ్డ్ ఇంటూ సమ్ కాంపౌండ్స్, దెన్ దే ఫార్మ్డ్ ఇంటూ మాలిక్యూల్స్, దెన్ దే ఫార్మ్డ్ ఇంటూ amino acids, nucleotides, nucleosides, itlaga. Then they formed into DNA. Some formed into chlorophyll, some formed into ribozymes. Yes, ala ala veltuna kodi, each and every organic material which is useful for the body, okti okti start ayindi. For example, chlorophyll, ribosome, went inside and started together to form a sheet that formed into a plant. అదొక సెల్ అయిపోయింది, ఒక ప్లాంట్ కింద ఫామ్ అయింది. క్లోరోఫిల్ ఇజంట్ దేర్, దెన్ ఇట్ స్టార్టెడ్ టు ఫార్మ్ సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్ విచ్ నౌ వీఆర్ సేయింగ్ యాజ్ హెటరోట్రోఫిక్ ఆర్గానిజం దాట్ గేవ్ రైజ్ ఇన్ టు యానిమల్స్ లైక్ అస్. ఎస్, సో ఇలాగ స్టేజ్ వైజ్గా ఇట్ టుక్ మెనీ లాంగ్ ఇయర్స్ టు ఫార్మ్ దిస్ లైఫ్ ఫామ్ విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్. సో ఫస్ట్ రికగ్నైజ్డ్ లైఫ్ ఫామ్ విచ్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఇస్ ది it is cyanobacteria, or we call it the blue green algae, or we can call this to be the first living organism or first life form on the earth. Now you understood? Yes, conservative heaps are nothing but all the organic matter which help to form any kind of organism which is there. So first life form was formed inside the water. So after that, slowly, slowly, then they became amphibians. What are amphibians? Amphi means both, which can live on water and which can live on land also. Example, frogs, some kind of snakes, yes, all these. Then slowly, these organisms came upon to terrestrial organisms. Terrestrial on land. Okay, they can be reptiles, they can be humans, they can be plants, they can be anything. Then slowly it went to arboreal organisms, that is nothing but which can fly, that are birds and all other organisms which are there. Clear? This is how the life has started. Done? So the third one, which is there, which is organic evolution, was mostly accepted by many of the scientists because for experimentation purposes also it had provided many evidences and all. Okay, here what happens is clearly you can know what are the mutations which were there. Because of mutations only the DNA structures have been changed, or you can say that because of that only you could have new characters which are there. As I said, mutation is nothing but any change or any sudden change, either at the time of formation of DNA or either at the time of replication of DNA. DNA form avutundi kada, maniki inni characters unnai ante adi DNA valle untundi. Yes, it makes a copy then and there, again and again, and the copy chestu untundi, so that we need to develop. And also it stores all our characters man next generation ki elladaniki undadaniki. Ilaagi idi form avutunappudu characters bayataki project chestunappudu protein formation appudu enti ante any kind of change it can be due to temperature, okay, due to any kind of shocks which are there, due to any kind of chemicals which are there, or spontaneously deni vallaina any change ayind ankonde vache character maaripothundi. Yes or no? So if that character is changed in the DNA, that is carried on again and again, next generations kuda adi carry avutundi, so that we call it to be mutations. So evaithe maniki life form lo start lo change ayyayo, next generations ki adi carry avutu vachindi kabatti maniki evolution anedi vachindi. So mutation was very important. So in this organic evolution we had changes or evidences like ఆర్గానిజం చేంజెస్ ఏవైతే ఉన్నాయో స్పెసిఫిక్లీ, లైక్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఎండోసింబయాటిక్ థియరీ అంటారు. ఎండో మీన్స్ ఇన్సైడ్, సింబయోసిస్ మీన్స్ హెల్పింగ్ ఈచ్ అదర్, మ్యూచువలిజం. ఇందులో ఎగ్జాంపుల్, ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ దేర్ ఆర్ టూ డిఫరెంట్ సబ్స్టెన్సెస్. ఇక్కడ మనం ఇక్కడ సెకండరీ కాంపౌండ్స్ ఆర్గానిక్ కాంపౌండ్స్ చెప్పుకున్నాం కదా, అమైనో యాసిడ్స్ అవునా, న్యూక్లియోటైడ్స్, న్యూక్లియోసైడ్స్, రైబోజోమ్స్, క్లోరోఫిల్. ఎస్, ఇలా ఇండివిజువల్గా ఒకటి ఒకటి ఫామ్ అయ్యాయి. యాక్చువల్లీ మన సెల్లో ఇవన్నీ చిన్న చిన్న ఆర్గనల్స్ లాగా ఉంటాయన్నమాట. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వీల్ టేక్ ఓన్లీ టూ థింగ్స్, వీ టేక్ రైబోజోమ్స్ అండ్ వీ టేక్ క్లోరోఫిల్. దే టుగెదర్ ఫార్మ్ టు ఫార్మ్ దీస్ ఆర్గానిక్ కాంపౌండ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ దేర్, రైబోజోమ్స్ అండ్ ది క్లోరోఫిల్. ఇట్ ఫార్మ్డ్ అ పర్మనెంట్ స్ట్రక్చర్ అవుట్ సైడ్, ఆర్ యూ కెన్ కాల్ ఇట్ ది స్కిన్ విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్ అవుట్ సైడ్. మనకి ఎట్లా స్కిన్ ఉంది, అన్ ఆర్గానిక్ సబ్స్టెన్స్ లైక్ దట్ యూ హ్యావ్ పర్మియబుల్ ఔటర్ లేయర్ విచ్ ఇస్ ఫార్మ్డ్ ఆర్ ది ప్రొటెక్టివ్ లేయర్ అవుట్ సైడ్ విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్. ఇక్కడ ఏమవుతుందంటే వాట్ విల్ యువర్ క్లోరోఫిల్ డూ, యూ హ్యావ్ your food, can we prepare our own food? Can or cannot? Cannot. Why we can't prepare our own food? We are not autotrophs, that's correct. Chlorophyll ledu atla cheppakoddu, we are not autotrophs. Not only chlorophyll, you have other pigments were very light, 0.0001% ఫుడ్ ప్రిపేర్ చేసుకోగలుగుతాయి అవి. ఓకే, ఆటో బై ఆర్ సెల్ఫ్, వీఆర్ హెట్రోట్రోప్స్, వీ డిపెండ్ ఆన్ అదర్స్ ఫర్ ఆర్ ఫుడ్. సో ఈ క్లోరోఫిల్ ఫిల్ చేస్తుంది, బాగుంది. మరి ఆ క్లోరోఫిల్ ఒక ఆర్గానిజంతో ఆగిపోతే, yes, if that chlorophyll for example is restricted only by myself, naku okkar daan daggara chlorophyll unnadi, appude em avutundi, na food nen prepare cheskuntan and I'll die. Yes, I'll not give that mechanism to others. If ribosome is present, what will happen? It can create a protein, it can have a base for the formation of DNA, and it can inculcate this chlorophyll into its DNA. So na next generation will be having the capability to produce chlorophyll. Now you understood? Yes, how this transformed, that transformed or that is transferred due to the changes which occurred here. Ikkada ila explain chesi odlesaru, dan tarvata cheppaledu. Organic evolution has explained from here, like how DNA has transformed, how this is going to one generation to another and all. So ikkada em avutundi, chlorophyll is preparing its own food, ribosome ki preparation raadu, it should depend on other materials. So whatever food this is giving, దిస్ ఇస్ ఈటింగ్ అండ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ దిస్ ఇస్ దేర్. ఈ క్లోరోఫిల్ని మళ్ళీ రెప్లికేట్ చేయడానికి ఈ రైబోజోమ్ యూజ్ అవుతుంది. దీనివల్ల ఏమవుతుంది? దిస్ ఇస్ బికమింగ్ అ వెరీ బిగ్ ఆర్గానిజం. Yes, a single-celled organism, a unicellular organism. Now you understood? This is very small thing which I said. Ilaga, different organelles together it has formed to form one organism which is there. So this is your organic evolution. Now, deeniki evidence undali kada? Idi evidence elaga ante, it had done many experiments. Like light discharge avutundi kada? UV rays vastayi. Like they took the methane, they took ethane, they took carbon dioxide and many other experiments, okay? Like chemical experiments la experimentation chesaru. Kani ikkada organic evolution matram, they took many evidences. Like, evidences like this, very few I'll explain in that. You know what are fossils, right? The fossil fuels means totally diminished fossils which are there, totally converted into carbonized materials like coal or all other things which are there. Fossils are nothing but very recently, like dinosaur eggs, dinosaurs, the skeletons and all which are there are known as fossils. Daninchi manki DNA ostundi kada? Yes, from the DNA they could do experiments and they could say how the mutations have occurred. Next, by embryological evidences like homologous organs and analogous organs. For example, we have the hand, for example, if you take the hand limb, okay, the skeletal structure of your hand limb. Adi whale ki teeskuna sare, human ki teeskuna sare, if you take for a bird, everything, the limb structure will be the same. But they use it for different purposes. The functions will be different. Auna, what will your whale do with this forelimb? Forelimb means upper limb which is there. It will swim. What we will do? To catch hold of something or do some other functional things which are there. What will a bird do? It will use it for flying. It will never use that for catching. Catching ki hind limbs which are there, adi use chestadi. Or the rear limbs which are present. Now you understood? So alaga functional differences they will be having. Or second thing, analogical differences. Now wings of a butterfly, for example, wings of a bat teeskondi. If you see wings of a butterfly ki meeku ekkada skeleton kanipinchudu. But they are used for flying. Bat ki wings untai kada, they are also used for flying, but it has these bones, limbs and everything whatever we have. Yes, now you understood? So these are the other differences. So maniki ee embryological deentlo or this organic evolution lo cheppedi entante, each and every life form will be having its own ancestor. You know who are ancestors? Forefathers. Father, grandfather, great-grandfather, great-great-grandfather. So ancestor unnadi ante ardham enti? So there is a common origin. Now you understood? So that common origin had given into different evolution. Clear? Yes. If you read out other books, eppudaina meeru bigger libraries ki velthe inka ekkuva untai, chaala ekkuva hypothesis, theories, many things will be there. Mottam biology anta teeskochi aa starting lone pedtharu, anta assalu akkarledu asalu. Okay, this much is needed for your exam, that is enough. Clear? Sorry, last thing, connecting links. Connecting links ante, for example, heard this one? Archaeopteryx. Archaeopteryx is actually an animal which has bird-like wings, but it is a reptile. ఓకే, చూసేసరికి నార్మల్ రెప్టైల్ లాగా ఉంటుంది, బట్ బర్డ్ లాగా పెద్ద వింగ్స్ ఉంటాయి దానికి. ఆ వింగ్స్ కూడా మళ్ళీ ఫెదర్డ్ వింగ్స్ కాదు, దే ఆర్ మేడ్ అప్ ఆఫ్ స్కెలిటన్. సో వాట్ యూ క్యాన్ హైపోథసైజ్ బై దిస్, దీనివల్ల నీకు వాట్ యూ కెన్ సే ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఓకే, బర్డ్స్ కుడ్ హ్యావ్ ఎవాల్వ్డ్ ఫ్రమ్ టెరెస్ట్రియల్ ఆర్గానిజమ్స్. మన ఇందాక చూసుకున్నప్పుడు లైఫ్ అన్నది aquatic నుంచి స్టార్ట్ అయింది కదా, వాటర్ ల్యాండ్ దెన్ ఎయిర్ విచ్ ఇస్ దేర్. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ అ కనెక్టింగ్ లింక్ బిట్వీన్ ది ల్యాండ్ అండ్ ఎయిర్ విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్. సో అలాగా డిఫరెంట్ హైపోథసిస్ బాగా ఎక్కువ వి గాట్ ఇట్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఆర్గానిక్ ఎవల్యూషన్ విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్. క్లియర్నా? హోమోలోగస్ ఆర్గన్స్లోని మీకు సిమిలర్ ఉంటుంది కదా, ద ఎంబ్రియోలాజికలీ సిమిలర్ ఉంటుంది. అనలాగస్ ఆర్గన్స్లో ఫంక్షనలీ సిమిలర్ ఉంటారు. బటర్ఫ్లై అండ్ అ బ్యాట్ యూ టేక్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, ఫంక్షనలీ బోత్ ద హ్యాండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్స్ ఆర్ సేమ్, దే కెన్ ఫ్లై. బట్ ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ ఎంబ్రియోలాజికలీ, బటర్ఫ్లైకి యూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ వింగ్స్, సారీ యూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ దీస్ బోన్స్ అండ్ లింబ్స్. ఓకే, లింబ్ అంటాం మనం దానికి, అది స్కెలిటల్గా టెండాన్స్ ఇవేమీ ఉండవు దానికి. బట్ ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ బ్యాట్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్, బట్ యూ బోత్ ఆర్ యూస్డ్ ఫర్ ఫ్లయింగ్. సో ఫంక్షనలీ సిమిలర్, ఎంబ్రియోలాజికలీ ఆర్ మార్ఫలాజికలీ డిఫరెంట్, దిస్ ఆపోజిట్ ఆఫ్ దట్. ఎండోసింబయాటిక్ థియరీ అంటే, ఎండో మీన్స్ ఇన్సైడ్, సింబయాసిస్ ఇస్ మ్యూచువల్, మ్యూచువల్గా హెల్ప్ చేసుకోవడం. Plants will have ribosomes to make proteins. అదే ఫస్ట్ అన్నది తెలీదు, కానీ ఫస్ట్ వచ్చింది ఆటోట్రోప్స్ కాదు, హెటరోట్రోప్సే ఫస్ట్ వచ్చాయి, దాని తర్వాత ఆటోట్రోప్స్ వచ్చాయి. హ్యూమన్ అనలేము, బ్యాక్టీరియా. Done. and all which live in air. Terrestrial which live exclusively on land. No, no, arboreal is air. Amphibian is both on water and land. Arboreal mostly which spend most of the time in air. Birds. Arboreal organisms. First, no, it is like how life has evolved. First in water, then slowly into amphibians which could live on land and water, then it came to terrestrial. In the meanwhile only, like for example, if you take mangroves and wetlands, which is a mixture of water and land, there you find birds a lot. Why? They need land, of course, and also they need the air which is there. Yes, so that's why I've given over there. Yes, so after life has originated, life has evolved, now life is everywhere now in this biosphere. Like you have arboreal organisms, you have terrestrial, you have water, you have microorganisms, and you have many organisms now. For example, if you take an insect, okay, insect is kunar, or you took an organism. Now, by then seeing the organism, you cannot say, for example, if you take an insect, okay. Immediately you cannot say which class this insect depends on, okay, or this insect is of this name, this insect is of this species, or it can do this, it is venomous or not, it is toxic or not. Now how is it helpful for that environment? It is increasing day by day. Is it good or is it bad for the environment? Choose inventor, you cannot know that, kada. Yes or no? We need to do some experiment on that. Okay? What if you have done this experiment and you have placed everything? Avuna? Chesunte appudu immediate ga nu cheppochu kada? Okay. This is this organism. It raakunda untene mana environment baaguntadi. Immediately you will diminish it. Yes or no? That is what your body will do. Your immunity will do like that. Now coronavirus had come. It started to spread everyone. What did we do? We started to experimentalize. We started to prepare the vaccine which is there. And slowly, slowly it is decreasing. So like that, what if we can classify everything? Choose in one, okay, this is autotroph, this is a plant. This is heterotroph, this is an animal. Ila manam classify cheskunte, it is very easy to do later functions or experiments or any kind of research on that. Yes, so that branch of either you can take biology or any branch related to that, which checks on the differentiation, is known as classification. Classification is nothing but sorting. You sort it. Library kelte untai chundi, social science, mathematics, English and all which is there. Like that, depending on similarities and dissimilarities. Or you can say differences. Okay? You differentiate an organism, that is known as classification. After you classify, you will be giving it a name which is a scientific name. Clear till there? Now, coming to your classification, you have many things. Many scientists have developed into different classifications like two kingdom, three kingdom, eight kingdom, like that there were many classifications which went on. Carl Wu's classification, okay, ilaga you had many. But the most accepted classification was five kingdom classification. Now what are the similarities, what are the dissimilarities, whatever and all I'm not dealing. That is not at all related to your subject which is there. I'll just say what are present inside that. E five kingdoms enti ante, he took all the plants and he placed in plant A. All the animals into animalia. Like that he divided into five different kingdoms. I'll be writing it down. But this also have many limitations. Limitations ante enti, ippudu chaala mattu kotta organisms vastayi. You could not know where they are placed. Now in this five kingdom classification, nowhere you will be finding viruses. Now where are these viruses then? Where will be keeping these viruses? ఓకే. సో ఇట్స్ లైక్ దాట్. అలాగే నీకు మళ్ళీ 8 కింగ్డమ్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్ వచ్చింది, అది అవ్వలేదని 13 కింగ్డమ్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్ కూడా వచ్చింది, వేర్ బ్యాక్టీరియాలోనే యూ హ్యాడ్ 3 కింగ్డమ్స్ విచ్ ఇస్ దేర్. సో అలా అలా మనం తీసుకుంటే దే ఆర్ మెనీ క్లాసిఫికేషన్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ దే, బట్ ఎగ్జామ్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో దిస్ ఇస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్. 5 కింగ్డమ్ అనే దానికన్నా హూ ప్రపోజ్డ్ 5 కింగ్డమ్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్, ఈ క్వశ్చన్ చాలాసార్లు వచ్చింది. ఇట్ ఈస్ విట్టేకర్ హూ వాజ్ దేర్, అందుకనే వీ కాల్ ఇట్ యాజ్ విటేకర్స్ 5 కింగ్డమ్ క్లాసిఫికేషన్. క్లియర్? ఆర్ ప్లాంట్ కింగ్డమ్, యానిమలియా యానిమల్ కింగ్డమ్, ప్రొటిస్టా ఆర్ ప్రోటోసిస్టా, ప్రో మీన్స్ ప్రిమిటివ్, ప్రిమిటివ్ ఆర్గానిజమ్స్, మొనెరా ఇస్ యూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ద యూ క్యారియాన్, క్యారియాన్ అంటే డిఎన్ఏ అది డెవలప్ అవ్వకుండా ఉంటుంది, ద స్టార్టింగ్ ఆర్గానిజమ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ దేర్, దోస్ ఆల్ ఆర్ ప్లేస్డ్ ఇన్ టు దిస్ మొనెరా విచ్ ఇస్ దేర్. దెన్ యూ హ్యావ్ దిస్ ఫంగై, ఫంగై ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ మష్రూమ్స్ ఉంటాయి కదా, థాలస్ లైక్ ఆర్గానిజమ్స్ అంటే పాకుతాయి, దే స్ప్రెడ్, ఓకే, క్లైంబర్స్ లాగా ఉండవు, ఓకే. సో దోస్ ఆర్ నోన్ యాజ్ దీస్ ఫంగై విచ్ ఆర్ దేర్. సో దీస్ ఆల్ వేర్ ఇన్ టు హిస్ కింగ్డమ్. మొనరా మీన్స్ నార్మలీ యువర్ డిఎన్ఏ విచ్ ఇస్ ప్రెజెంట్ ఇస్ ఎన్క్లోజ్డ్ ఇన్ సైడ్ యువర్ క్రోమోజోమ్, బట్ ప్రిమిటివ్ ఆర్గానిజమ్స్లో నీకు టోటల్గా డిఎన్ఏ అనేది ఫామ్ అయి ఉండదు. ఇట్ ఇస్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ద బిగినింగ్ యూ హ్యాడ్ ప్లాస్మిడ్ లైక్, అంటే డిఎన్ఏ జస్ట్ అట్లా ఉండిపోతుంది ఒక ఆర్గానిజంలో. సో దోస్ ఆర్ నోన్ యాజ్ విచ్ ఆర్ నాట్ కవర్డ్, విచ్ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ అ వెల్ డెవలప్డ్ కేరియాన్స్, అలాంటి ఆర్గానిజమ్స్ అన్నిటినీ మనం మొనరలో పెడతాం. స్ప్రెడ్ అని కాదు, డిఎన్ఏ ఎన్క్లోజ్ అయి ఉండదు. యూ కెనాట్ సే డైరెక్ట్లీ యాప్స్ డిఎన్ఏ అని యూజ్ చేయము, జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ అంటాం యాక్చువల్లీ. ఇట్ ఈస్ లైక్ యూ హ్యావ్ ప్లాస్మిడ్స్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, యూ కాంట్ సే ఇట్ ఇస్ సెల్ మెమరీ, యూ కెన్ సే ఎన్క్లోజర్ ఆఫ్ జెనెటిక్ మెటీరియల్ లేకుండా ఉన్నది అని. ప్రొటెస్టా ఈజ్ ప్రిమిటివ్ ఆర్గానిజమ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ దేర్. నా మొనెరా కమ్స్ టు ద primitive bacteria algae which were starting, like you can say blue green algae which is present in the stand which cannot come in. No, fungi is different. No, fungi is mushroom, for example mushroom is a fungi, or bread mold is a fungi, athlete's foot disease is a fungi, scabies is a fungi, yes, those all are fungus, all of that. No, virus is not at all included in this. That only I specified for you, no? There is a limitation. Viruses and other organisms aren't there here. Yes, you can say bacteria is present here. Many of the bacteria. Monero also has certain bacteria, but the genetic material doesn't have any kind of enclosure. Like you don't have any kind of protection for it. It is directly present inside the cell which is there as a cell organelle. See, our DNA is enclosed inside your nucleus, inside your chromosome and all which is present. So it is enclosed. Here it is not like that. It is just left like that because it is so primitive and it is not developed. Primitive bacteria which are there, xerocoles and all other organisms which are there. Or you can find these organisms in sulfur vents and all. So those kind of organisms are these monera.